Probably not the bridge you want to choose if you're heading to New Jersey. Now, the other major roads in New Jersey are jammed too. 295 from 70 northbound side heading from Delphi Drive up to Route 30. And it's jamming 42 northbound on the ramp to get to 295 north. Just a rough day in the Garden State. Now, if you're leaving the Garden State, you and many others have decided to do so on the Ben Franklin Bridge. It is crawling all the way across, and now we're seeing a delay on the Commodore Ferry all the way across, heading back into New Jersey. Oof. All right, 95 southbound is slow from the Walt Whitman Bridge all the way down to 322. We're seeing delays on the Blue Route southbound from St. David's almost down all the way to 95 as well. That's the bailout traffic. On the Schuylkill, your typical delay from King of Prussia down into the city, about a 50-minute ride, not counting your Walt Whitman Extension excursion if you're heading to New Jersey. Jammed on 95 north between Cottman and Woodhaven. Earlier construction, the culprit there. So the Turnpike eastbound, Heavy Valley Forge to Mid-County. We're looking at your typical delays on 422 from 202 out to Trooper. Mass Transit, no major problems. Now we're getting an eastbound problem on the Commodore Ferry Bridge. Now we're being told that is an accident. Next update in less than 10 minutes from the Trumark Financial 24-Hour Traffic Center, where member banking is better banking. I'm Brian Ribona.
You may have equity in your leased Mercedes. Keenan Motors, your Mercedes-Benz dealer in Doylestown, needs quality pre-owned Mercedes to keep up with strong demand. Call Danny at 215-348-0800 to learn how returning your leased Mercedes to Keenan can return cash to you.
This is CBS 3 meteorologist Kate Bilo. Mostly cloudy tonight with a stray shower or storm, low 71. Tomorrow, sun and clouds, high 85. An isolated shower or storm mainly off to the south. Friday, mostly sunny, high 88. On Saturday, partly sunny, a little more humid, high 89 with an overnight shower or storm. Sunday, partly sunny again with a pop-up shower, high 90. And we're at 91 degrees Monday, again with a chance for an afternoon thunderstorm. Eyewitness weather updates 8 times every hour on KYW News Radio.
Don't miss the Sand Sculpture Spectacular at the Stops at Liberty Place. 40 tons of sand transformed into this one-of-a-kind masterpiece on display in the Rotunda. The Stops at Liberty Place, located at 16th and Chestnut Street.
Time to check in with our friends at CBS 3 Eyewitness News. Joining us, CBS 3 anchor Jessica Dean. Yes, among the stories coming up at 6, focus on some first responders.
That's right, Steve. Today at 6 o'clock, our Stephanie Shaw is and a story that focuses on firefighters. Of course, we know they are incredible heroes who give up so much and work so hard to keep all of us safe. They face incredible hazards beyond the fires that they fight, which is hazard enough, but they have other things that face them as well, including a higher risk of obesity, diabetes, heart disease, depression, and also stress. Imagine. So the question becomes, how do you care for the whole firefighter after they've done their work? And that's what Stephanie is talking about today.
Jessica Dean with us on Reporters Roundup.
Thank you.
Now the KYW Business Report. Stocks fell in midweek trading. The Bears moved in and stayed for a while. The Dow closed down 219 points, 24,700. NASDAQ closed down 42.5 points, 7,716, S&P 500 down nearly 20 points, and the Beneficial Bank Philadelphia Index and Bloomberg down just over 1%. We check in with KYW Business Analyst Bob Manning of Morgan Stanley Wealth Management. New tariffs on China announced last night, Bob. So what was the sentiment on Wall Street about the
Wall Street's response was somewhat mild. 오늘 삼촌
Now the announcement was not out of the blue. A lot of the impact has been discounted in prices already. Now the real very short-term concern is, let's face it, are we closer to the beginning, middle, or end of this issue? We just don't know, Steve, creating uncertainty, and as we know also, that's no fun for Wall Street, you know. And crude on a bit of a roller coaster ride, dropping 5% this session. What was behind that?
Wow, you know, see, if the Dow fell 5%, the Dow would have dropped over 1,200 points, and that would be a big headline. Crude down 5% because Libya increased production, and the trade issue reducing demand of the possibility.
Thank you.
one call number, alerting your local utility companies to come out and mark any lines they have near your dig site. So before you do this or this, make sure you do this.